time we've heard this. But it's a great day for the players and for the families, and of course for the supporters who've been absolutely magnificent.
I imagine you were bursting with pride coming along that route, just a mile and a half, but you could have lapped that up all day.
Yeah, that's understated, because it was that much warmth and that much pleasure. And
there's
my best mate, and he's coming to see you. Brilliant. See me in my office Monday.
When you first came to the club, do you remember the first day you walked through the door?
I do, yeah. I'd left Manchester City and been out of work, and then when Sunderland come calling, the club is massive. Well, it's massive. And it was just, it was having a sticky spell. And I got the job for seven games. Now, this is short rain. Seven games, because we're at the bottom of the, what was the first division, is now the Championship. And then, remember the first game, I think it was on April Fool's Day, and Sheffield United were going for promotion. Harry Bassett was in charge and he had a good side. But to be fair, the crowd at Old Road could come out, and support was fantastic. And if I'm not mistaken, I put Craig Russell on and he stuck one in, got him in the inside left position, drilled one in the bottom corner, which was a massive, massive game because it did everything for the conference. So I remember that really, really well.
It started by keeping the lads up.
They did brilliant.
It was a gradual process as well, wasn't it? I mean, there was a lot of heartache on the way through the good times as well.
Oh, well, that's football. That's football. I mean, the boys, when you come in cold and you don't know, and I think Bawley was suspended. Well, he might have broke his jaw. It might have been both with him. So, you were missing your skipper. I remember Gary Bennett was injured. So in training, I'd seen Richard Ord and Melville. And I had a short-sided game because I just wanted to just see him. Richard Ord was brilliant. So I put them at centre-back, and then the likes of Agnew and Phil Gray and, Kubici and Martin Scott. Martin Smith, you could see Smithy had fantastic ability. So there was some quality there, but the fixtures we had, them players to keep the club in the league at that time did a terrific job. And then following season was just ridiculous, getting promotion with the boys. They did absolutely fantastic. I think I brought Brace in. As my assistant, I brought Sacco in as first team coach, and they were big personalities, but the crowd sort of bought into it, and it sort of got onto a roller coaster, I've got to say, the likes of Melville, Audie, Bawley, Mickey Gray come to the fore, all these people. Brace was magnificent. Brace was magnificent, and it was just Agnew, but dude, they all put in a great shift, and we got that promotion, which was fantastic.
But from that, obviously, the record breaking point season was a phenomenal sort of comeback.
It was a good side, and I think you mentioned that the crowd bought into it, and some of the displays out here were absolutely outstanding, and it was a real good period for me as personally, but for the football club it was fantastic. And then the couple of years we had in the Premiership, we give anyone a game here. They didn't like coming up to the stadium, because we were awesome. I mean, the first season up, I think we got beat at Stamford Bridge, and got well beat, and it was just a wake up call about how good the league is. And then I think on the midweek we beat Watford here 1-0. I think Kevin Phillips scored, and then we just went on a great roll. And the biggest thing for me that season, the corresponding game here after the first, it was in December, and we played Chelsea, and I think we were four up after about 22 minutes. The lads were like ridiculous. The crowd, and that was an unbelievable display because we had a load of injuries. Me two central midfield players that day, have a guess who they were? I bet you can't guess.
No.
Eric Waugh, he's a French lad I bought in.
We never got that one.
And Paul Farewell, playing against Poirier and Zola, and we beat him. We were four. Quinn got two and Phillips got two, and it was unbelievable because I just thought, you know, we've got it all on here. But it was the club and the support was on such a roll, like I just mentioned, we'd give anybody a game out here, and we did invariably week in, week out.
And you mentioned with that as well, at Roker Park as well as here, the fans, like I say, really bought into it, and they got behind the team week after week as well.
I think the crowd wanted magnificent. And the biggest thing about biggest compliment I can pay this stadium is that Roker Park held so many memories and was a great old stadium. I think the transition over wasn't really, it went that smooth. You know, people bought into the new place, even though it's sad to see Roker Park go because it's been such a brilliant ground and such a historic, traditional, atmospheric ground. This, for me, is one of the newest, but it's got an atmosphere. I go to some new grounds and they're like libraries. There's not, this one, it was on fire. You know what I mean? And like you said, the crowd bought into it because football clubs are about people. You know, I mean, I've been a manager here. I loved it, but it moves on. But it's the people who have football clubs, and certainly the people in Sunderland are brilliant, i.e. a brilliant football club.
It must be incredibly humbling for yourself to come back to the North East time and time again, and just people come up to you in the streets or wherever and say, look, I remember the days when you were in charge and it was amazing.
Well, I mean, I've travelled the world in football, and you'd be surprised which part of the world people come up to you, and you know, Sunderland fans, and it's always that's one of the beauties about being at top level sport, you know, as a player and as a manager, and it still gives you a thrill, yeah, without a doubt. I mean, like I said before, for me to be a manager of a football club this big, it's an honour. And then at 7.5 years, it's fantastic. You know, it was a brilliant time for myself, and a successful period for the football club.
And just finally, if you could go back tomorrow and start all again, would you?
In terms of being a manager here?
Yep.
Oh, without a doubt. Yeah. It's a great football club, you know, and every week there's 40,000 people turn up to watch their team. It don't get any better than that. And they are going to be a big influence on the club staying in this league. And off camera, I said, I think Sunderland will stay up. I think it's going to be hard, but I think that Sunderland will stay up. I think Sam will do it and the players. And one of the big helps will be the support. So get out there and support the lads.